All right, we're going to go into the settings around time tracking. So take a look first. If we go into accountant settings, then we go down to advanced and scroll down to time tracking. So there's two preferences in here. The first one says add service field to timesheets. So this is always recommended, especially if you're billing through to the customer. So it's saying which service item are you going to bill the customer for? So I do HVAC work. So I'm on my timesheet, I want my employee to choose HVAC services so that when I bill it through to the customer, it shows HVAC services. HVAC services points to an income account, right? Services income or whatever it is. But I can run subledger reports to see detail of how much do we do for HVAC services versus pool cleaning services or whatever it is. Okay, so always recommended, add service field to timesheets. That should always be a yes. Then it says, should we make single time activity billable to the customer? Again, this is if you're going to do time and materials billing. So if you're going to bill, you know, Johnny puts in an hour of time, and when Johnny puts in an hour of time, it's going to trigger you next time. So Johnny puts an hour of time into Fourlane, let's say. Then it's going to trigger you next time you go to create an invoice to Fourlane. Hey, you have some outstanding time that you need to bill through to the client. Okay. Now, if we're just job costing labor and we do like fixed bid, we do not turn on making things billable to the customer, because you can still put the customer on the time card, so it'll still track the expense tied to the customer, but you're not going to create an invoice based off of that exact time, right? So if you do fixed bid billing, don't turn this on. Just adds weight to the system that you don't need. If you do time and materials billing, then you want to have this turned on. Okay, so then we have show billing rate to users entering time. Most of the time, this is not going to be checked, because basically this is saying, you know, Tommy, I'm billing you out at $100 an hour. Now, sometimes it is good to show this, right? Because maybe when Tommy puts in his time card, Tommy gets to decide if he can bill this client $100 an hour or $200 an hour. And he's responsible for those margins, so we want him to be able to see it. Most times, businesses don't want their employees knowing how much we're billing them out at, right? Because it's going to be 3 to 4X of what we pay them. They start doing the math and can get frustrated sometimes. It's not great to have it in front of them. But I'm going to leave it checked so you can see what this means. Then here's also where we choose what is the first day of the work week. It's just what is our cycle, right? If we're billing for the week, when we go into weekly time cards, what is going to be the first day? So I'm going to leave it as Sunday and say save. So let's go see what all these things mean. So we exit out of settings. First of all, when I come in to payroll, I'm just going to pop up a message and say all the things. But when I come in to employees here and I add a new employee, not right now, payroll, thank you. So we're just going to go ahead and add in Tommy Smith as an employee, right? I have all the information I can fill in on the employee. I have my cost rate. So this is a stated rate. This is meant to be when you use projects, right? So let's say we pay Tommy $15 an hour. That's his pay rate. And then on top of that, of course, we have to pay food and soda and all of the things, right? Whatever additional fees we have to choose. So instead of putting a cost rate of $15, we're going to put a loaded cost rate, right? Usually people do that as like a 1.2 or 1.3 times their actual hourly rate. So if I take 15 times 1.2, I get $18. So my cost rate I'm going to put in for Tommy is $18. Okay, so that's that. Then we have our bill rate. Okay, our bill rate on Tommy, we're going to say, again, 3 to 4X. I'm just going to round it up 4X right now for $80. This is what we're going to bill Tommy out at, is $80. Okay, and then you have this checkbox that says automatically make all Tommy's time billable by default. It's a great little feature you can add in here, because otherwise Tommy might have to choose that every single time on his time card. So we have Tommy set up now. Now we come over here to new, and there's two different things. We have weekly timesheet. So we take a look at our weekly timesheet. Okay, and we're going to enter for Tommy. Now, 4/18 to 4/24, we said it starts on a Sunday. So 4/18 was a Sunday. So that's what it means when you say, what is the start of my work week? Okay. A lot of people do Mondays, not Sundays. Then down here, you can choose what's the customer project that they're working on, right? And it picks up what's that default cost rate. It's showing that there. What's the class? What's the division? So we have that. What service? So this is where we added in that service item, that checkmark box that says show the service item. If I did not check that off, it would not show here. It defaults to billable, and it is showing the rate that I'm going to bill Tommy out at on this. Okay, so all of those fields are going to show up on the weekly timesheet. Then, of course, you put in here 2, 8, whatever it is. These will all show up on the weekly timesheet. Save. So, so you want to save it? Yes, I didn't put classes and all the things. And then, of course, we have the single time activity, which are the exact same fields, right? It's just one at a time that you're entering in. Bill rate, cost rate, all the things are in here. I wonder if it'll let me. Well, let me change. Oh, look at that. It'll let me change the cost rate on the single one. That's kind of weird. Strange. And you can do start and stop times, right? So you can do it based on time, etc. So then, what does this mean when we come into projects? I will be able to see under Adam's Casita, right? Time activity. So here's that $180 of cost, right? Turning into $800 of time. So time activity is showing in here when we're looking at our overall costs. $180 will go into those costs on projects. And then, of course, when I go in and create an invoice to Adam's Casita, right, I can add that billable time to my invoice. So they're going to pop up over here, shows those hours, the service date, quantity, what the rate is, right? So all of that pops up. So that's how the workflow. Okay, that is the setting for time.